Joining us once again is Julie Blais Comeau. She is an etiquette expert. Now, you and I spoke about the origins of afternoon tea earlier this morning, whether pinkies up or pinkies down, and we identified and confirmed that pinkies down when drinking your tea.
That's right.
But now we are moving on to the do's and don'ts of etiquette at the beach, at the pool, and at the workplace. Very important. A lot of people work in un-air-conditioned spaces, and it's very hot. But yes, I think it's still important to maintain professionalism when dressing, right?
Yes, you're absolutely right, Sarah. You know, what's important to remember is that foremost, we dress for our client. Mm-hmm. So it has to make sense. It has to be credible. It has to be coherent for our client. Doesn't matter what season it is. Doesn't matter what time it is. It has to make sense. If you're an accountant for Lady Gaga, well, maybe you can get away with the leopard skirt.
Right.
But if you're an accountant for someone that's in a more serious business, well, maybe not. So you really want to think about, what would my client think?
Okay. So I should not go with the leopard one-piece suit for work tomorrow.
Unless you work for Lady Gaga.
Okay, well, I certainly don't, so I'll be leaving that in my closet. Where would you like to start? You mentioned that there are three B's.
Yes, at the office. So you do not want to wear beachwear. Beachwear is for the beach.
Okay.
Anything for the boudoir. So that means that Victoria's Secret should remain a secret. So we don't want to see bra straps. We don't want to see boxer shorts or anything like that. And then also barbell wear. Anything that you wear at the gym, you also don't want to see at the office. So at the beach, mm-hmm, at the boudoir, and barbell. Anything that you would wear at the gym, you also don't want to see at the office.
Now, what are your thoughts with regards to flip-flops in the professional environment?
Yes, well, do you remember, Sarah, last year, was it Renfrew County? They banned it. They said nobody in the city can wear flip-flops. And I agree, and I'll give you three reasons why. Three S's, the sights. First of all, do you really want to see the big toe of Big Boss? I don't think so.
Okay, I understand.
The second one is the sound. Let's say, you know, I'm preparing for a workshop and I go up and down to the photocopier all day. Mm-hmm. Flip, flop, flip, flop. And, you know, you're concentrating, getting ready for tomorrow's show. Mm-hmm. So that's the second S, sound. And then the third one, you come, you know, 5:30 in the morning, you're here and everything's nice and fresh, and then you decide to go out for lunch, and the third S would be the smell. You come back and maybe you're not smelling as fresh. So three reasons why I say no: the sight of the big toe, the smell of what could happen after lunch, mm-hmm, and then the sound, flip-flop. Okay. So no for the office.
Now, you've brought an entire setup for the beach here. Let's talk about proper etiquette at the beach or by the poolside.
Well, you know, you want to remember the same three S's: the sights, mm-hmm, the smells, and the sound. So let's start with the sound. You know, some people go to the beach and they'll plug into their iPod, maybe a stereo. Mm-hmm. Music is fine, but think about who else is going to be hearing that music around you. Also, make sure that it's safe. That lifeguard needs to be able to hear whatever's happening, whoever may be in distress. Also, let's talk about our cell phones. Mm-hmm. You know, it's time in the summer to enjoy each other. So screen time, probably not. Let's think about FaceTime. So maybe we want to put that away while we're visiting, while we're at the beach, while we're at the pool.
I find that particularly important. Some of us have become so reliant on our devices that oftentimes you can't even maintain a conversation with somebody,
yes,
because they are so glued to their phone.
And you know what people do now? They play phone step. So we all get there together, we all put our cell phones down, and the person that has that urge and reaches for that phone will pay the bill. So phone stack from now on, right?
Okay, I'd be leaving my phone there. Okay, now we've got some other items here. What does this picture represent?
Leave only behind your footprints. So when you go to the beach, take a bag with you, Sarah, any kind of bag, and make sure that you put inside that bag your diapers, any leftover food, and you know what, even the cigarette butts, biodegradable, but what did you say?
Over how many years? I mean, my goodness.
Exactly. So take everything, put it in the bag, leave only your footprints. When you get there, take off your flip-flops and those of your children. Other people are enjoying the sun, they're relaxing, and then, you know, flip-flop, all the sand comes up.
The sand flicking through the air. Yeah. Now, I've noticed that you've brought both a watermelon and a bottle of bubbly here. I would assume this isn't for you and I to have a good time after the interview.
Well, when we get an invitation to a pool, you want to bring what you're going to drink. So maybe I bring a bottle of Prosecco, maybe I bring a snack, I bring the toys that my children like. You have to bring everything that you're going to be needing with you. And also, don't forget, a hostess gift. And this one is for you. I make my own, every year, I make my own beer can chicken spices. So this is for you to enjoy. And you know,
people
really like that. So when you're invited at a pool, when you're invited at the cottage, make sure that you also leave a little something for them to enjoy throughout the summer.
Julie's a guest that that I'd love to have over at any time. Thank you so much. It was such a pleasure to meet you.
My pleasure.
And thank you for sharing all of these tips. Many of them seem like they would be common sense, but in fact, it's, you know, those little things that you sometimes forget. So thank you very much for that.
My pleasure. Have a great summer.
Thank you very much.